In this video, I will walk through how to configure a custom text search for a SAS Visual Analytics report. I will walk through building the required parameters, how to assign the correct roles for the text input control objects, and how to configure the filter. Let's get started with the demonstration. I will be using SAS Visual Analytics 2021.2.4 for the hands-on portion of the video, but the same techniques can be used in earlier releases starting with VA 7.5 and later. The first thing I want to show you or remind you is how the default behavior works for either report or page level prompts. Notice here that I have three prompts. The first one is a drop-down list for select year. When I activate the select year drop-down list object, we can see that I have the category date by year assigned to its role. For the first text input control object for product lines, we can see that I have the product lines assigned to the category role. And for the second text input control object, I have product description assigned to the category role. By default, the behavior is to use an equal to condition for filtering and combine multiple control objects with an AND operator. There's no way to change this default behavior, and the next portion of this demonstration will show you how to configure a custom text search string using a different filter condition. Let's go ahead and take a look at this default behavior. Notice that when I type action figure in the product line text input control and I click enter, we can see that it filters the below list table as expected. Next, if I type a different product line, if I type game, board, puzzles, and cards and hit enter, we can see that the list table is filtered as expected. If I wanted to also look at all of the puzzles, which have a piece in the product description, and I type piece here, we can see that I get no matches returned for this filter combination. This is not the result I want. Continue watching to find out how we can configure a more customized text search. I'm going to go ahead and toggle over to a similar report where we can build out our custom text search. Here you can see the same report design with the selected year dropdown, and this time I have two text input control objects that do not have any data role assignments yet. In order to create the custom text search, we will store the type text strings into parameters and build our own custom filter. So let's go ahead and create the products line parameter first. From the data pane, using the new data item window, I'm going to select parameter. I'm going to give it a name and type character. Character parameters do not require a default value, so we'll click OK. Next, I'm going to create a parameter to store the product description text string. From the new data item menu, select parameter, and we'll go ahead and give it a name of type character and click OK. Now we need to assign these parameters to our text input control objects. Go ahead and click on the first one, and instead of the category data role, we are going to use the parameter data role. When I click add, we can see that I have two parameters that have not yet been assigned to a control object. This is for the product line. And then for the second text input control object, we will use the product description parameter. What these parameter role assignments allow for is any text we type inside these text input controls will be stored in these parameters. Now we can configure our filter. I'm going to click on the list table to activate it and then use my filters pane. I'm going to select new filter and then advanced filter. Now let's build out our expression. We want to check to see if any text was entered. If text was entered in both text input controls and saved in our parameters, then we want to use a contains expression with an AND operator for both of the data items. So from the operators, we'll use an if-else statement, and the condition is to check to see if both parameters have values. So we're going to have to use an AND statement. And there is an operator called isSet that will check to see if a parameter has been set. So we'll add isSet to the first condition and the second condition. And now we need to check to see if both of our parameters' values have been set. We're going to check the product line parameter and the product description parameter. If both of these parameters do have values, so if this expression returns true, we want to return a contains filter expression for both of the source data items. So we're going to go back to our operators and get our AND condition. And we want it where if the data item contains our parameter value. So we're going to use our contains for both of the conditions. And then back on the data item tabs, the first one we'll do is for product lines. So if product line contains the parameter value, and then the other was a description. If product description contains the product description parameter. We could leave it at this, but I'm not really confident that my end user will get the case exactly correct. So in order to make this case insensitive, we're just going to upcase both sides of the equation. And therefore, we don't have to worry about if the user knows or gets the case correct. So I'm going to wrap an upcase around the first operand and then the parameter. And then again for the product description data item and the product description parameter. Now we've handled the case where text strings have been entered in both of the text input control objects. Now we need to handle the case where if only one of the parameters is set. We'll have to use another if-else operator. And we're going to have to test if only one of the parameters is set. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this expression. I'm going to paste it here in my if condition. And we want if one of these is set returns true and not the other one. So I'll just have to add a not in front of the second one. So now in looking at this, if this expression where product lines parameter is set and not the product description parameter, then we only want to return the expression where we return product lines, return the rows where the upcase of product line contains the upcase of our product line parameter. So we'll go ahead and copy this expression and paste it into the return true condition. Else, we know we need to return only the product description data item. So we'll go ahead and copy this expression and paste it in our false condition for this particular Boolean expression. We'll go ahead and give this a name and click OK. Now we can test. So for the products line search strings, if I type action figure, like I did before, we can see I still get the expected results. But now if I just type in figure, we can see that I get the returned rows where product line equals both action figure and stuffed animal figures. Let's go ahead and test our games. But instead of typing the entire value, I'm just going to type game. We can see I get both the game board puzzles and card values in addition to the promotional games items. And again, I was interested in the puzzles that contain the description piece. So here I'm just going to type it all lowercase because we can see that the mixed case is irrelevant because we have upcased both sides of the condition. We can see we get both game and the partial description for piece returning the expected results. Right now I've defined this filter for this particular list table. We may want to apply it to other report objects. We could easily go into the filter and into edit and grab the text of this filter and copy and paste it and apply it to another object Or, starting with VA 8.3, we now have the ability to make this filter a common filter, which is actually stored with the data source. So you can see down here at the bottom, the product lines and description filter is now saved with the data source that it's being applied to. And if I had other objects in my report, I can easily apply this filter. So on page 2, if I click on this list table, I can easily add a new filter and add my product lines and description filter. And we can see what I have already entered in my search string parameters gets immediately applied to this list table. I've now shown you how to configure a custom text search in your SAS Visual Analytics report. If you are interested in how to configure a custom filter conditions with either a measure or ID value, take a look at the accompanying blog where I walk through tips and tricks for how to configure the filters there. For this particular list table, we can see that I have a product ID search string, which is a character value. You can see for this particular custom filter, I use a starts with when I get the value that has been entered in that text input control object. And then on page 1, we saw that I also had a measure filter applied to this particular list table where I just use a greater than or equal to condition. For more information, please refer to the SAS Visual Analytics documentation or check out one of these videos or blogs. Thank you, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.